Dit is pas zijn hobby.
Goedemorgen, wij zijn helemaal ingepakt en klaar om te gaan. Want helaas was dit alweer de laatste nacht in het prachtige huis. Maar voordat we gaan, ga ik natuurlijk nog even van dit uitzicht genieten. Want kom op, waar vind je anders zo'n mooi uitzicht als dit? Zometeen gaan we naar een grot. Ik weet niet precies wat het verhaal achter die grot is, maar dat horen we vanzelf bij de tour. En daarna ga ik nog even een keer paardrijden. Hoi iedereen, het is Maya uit de toekomst. Ik wil nog even een kleine opmerking geven hierover. Sinds mijn reis in IJsland ben ik steeds meer gaan realiseren dat paardrijden niet echt in een vegan levensstijl thuis hoort. Maar hier was ik nog niet zo ver of zo. Ja, dat wilde ik gewoon even nog erbij zeggen. Dit keer in mijn eentje, een wat meer gevorderde rit. Lekker over dat strand wat je eigenlijk niet echt van hier kan zien. Waarschijnlijk over het strand. Dus daar heb ik echt ontzettend veel zin in. Maar eerst naar de grot.
Then we'll be going down here into White Tacongo Hall of Spirits. And then deeper down into another cave called Eder. Eder is an older cave, told to be about 10,000 years old cave. Possibly created in another eruption. We can't actually guarantee that.
Dat is dit. Het gaat door meteen koud.
I have a question for you. Do you believe in trolls?
Yes.
Of course. Everyone believes in trolls here in Iceland. Well, part of it. Snæfells House, he was a half a man and half a troll. He used to live in the glacier, Snæfells Glacier, and he came down here to have a meeting with the other trolls. Baldur used to sit here at this table in front of him, while the trolls used to sit down here, like 7-8 trolls, and the rest is laid down at this balcony over here. And this balcony goes in a 360 degree angle, so I guess Baldur had a lot of friends. We haven't actually seen Bárður or heard one of his meetings, but we believe he comes here sometimes. And we believe the last meeting was about these guided tours and making sure we don't harm the cave. And I don't want to mess with the health of man and health of troll, so I guess I have to listen to Bárður. Also, we believe he's not been here for a long time because, well, he still has his Christmas tree up. And why do you think it's so special?
Because of these little...
The stalactites? Yes.
Oh,
it's special though?
No.
If it would be on the surface, looking at this direction over here, we'd be seeing the crater's poof color. And when the activity underneath was starting, voila! Here's where the lava came in. And because of the massive heat that was going on, the roof collapsed. Fell down. You can see it on the stalactites that some of them are like this, and some of them are even like this. And if you believe in gravity, then this should not be like this. But when the roof collapsed, it blocked the lava. And the lava went somewhere else. Possibly making another lava tube, we cannot guarantee it. But as you can hear, there could be another cave underneath us. But hopefully we won't find that out today. And I guess we'll be pretty screwed. These stalactites are here like 7,000 years old. And the reason why they're not bigger than this is because, well, lava stalactites, they don't grow anymore. They're gonna be like this forever. This is one of the main reasons why the National Park wanted to close the cave, because it is really rare to have those close together. Also, they're empty inside, they're hollow. If you knock on them, you just hear an empty sound. So it's really easy to break them. But it takes about 6 hours to 8 hours to complete one twin. And stalagmites are created when the lava is dripping down from the ceiling. It's the opposite of the stalactites. It takes about 7 days, 1.5 weeks to complete one lava stalagmite. But this one over here is one of the biggest stalagmites in Iceland. And the gentleman who found this stalagmite actually named it after one of his body parts. Do you want to guess which body part it is? I give you a hint. A lot of people use this that a lot on Facebook, I guess.
Thumb.
Yes, it's the thumb, the like button. Take a look at this beautiful troll. Most of you can see it here are the teeth. The gnomes, and we have the magic and the elves. Yeah. But in our stories, when the trolls see the sunlight, it's kind of like in the movie Hobbit. When the trolls see the sunlight, they turn into stone. And her name was Mother-in-Law.
Wow, echt heel warm opeens. Kijk. Kijk, het is net de tweeling van in de grot. Alleen dan in het groot. Een picknick aan de zee. Picknicken op IJsland, op het strand. Yes.
Life goals.
Mega golf. Wow. Dit is pas zijn hobby. Dag, prachtig strand. We zijn nu weer in ons nieuwe huisje. Het is een soort studentenwoning die in de zomer wordt verhuurd aan gasten gewoon. De eigenaresse was super aardig. Ze kwam even alles uitleggen en zo. En nu gaan we lekker slapen, wat rusten. I walk with you.